Good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome to all who are worshiping with us on this, the third Sunday after Pentecost. And also, very happy Father's Day to our fathers and to all those who serve as a father in some way. Very glad to be leading worship this day while Pastor Brahmer is beginning the leadership of the confirmation camp. Stay in our prayers. We ask you to keep Pastor Brahmer, the adult leaders from this congregation, Elaine and Elizabeth, and the youth from the congregation who will be attending camp, Adam, Elsie, and Jordan. We ask you to keep all of them in our prayers. Also, a reminder of the announcement in the bulletin about the Love Inc. sneaker drive and distribution, that collection which begins today and continues through August the 2nd. This time, Rodney has an announcement.
Good morning. Good morning. I just wanted to bring your attention to an announcement in the bulletin insert. The Faith in Action is sponsoring a Feeding the Homeless, not tomorrow, but next Monday. Faith in Action is going to provide subs from R&K, subs. We're going to either have potato salad or macaroni salad to serve with it. And so we're looking for, if you're willing to donate some baked goods or sides, or I need some, you know, a few volunteers maybe to come down and help hand out the food there. So if you're interested in any of that, please let me know. My phone number and email are in the bulletin. And thank you.
Thank you. Today we hear stories of God calling his people to serve him, God leading his people, but also God reminding us that in all that he calls us to do, he provides the resources for us to do so. Let us rise and begin with our confession of sins. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, who looks upon us in compassion, forgives our sin, and heals our lives.
Amen.
Let us confess our sin in the presence of God and of one another. Have mercy, O God.
Against you alone, we have sinned.
In your compassion, cleanse us from our sin and take away our guilt.
Create in us a new heart and give us a steadfast spirit.
Fill us with your Holy Spirit and restore your joy within us.
Amen.
As tender as parent to child, so deep is God's compassion for you. As high as heaven is above earth, so vast is God's love for you. As far as east is from west, so far God removes your sin from you, renewing your life through Jesus Christ. By the mercy of God, we are united with Jesus Christ, in whom we are forgiven.
Amen.
Oh,
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Yeah.
Let us pray. God of compassion, you have opened the way for us and brought us to yourself. Pour your love into our hearts that, overflowing with joy, we may freely share the blessings of your realm and faithfully proclaim the good news of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
Amen. Amen.
We apparently are missing our reader for this morning, so I will be the last-minute substitute, and I will admit this is the first time I've ever been a reader in this church. Sometimes it calls for emergency. Our first reading is from Exodus, the 19th chapter. The Israelites had journeyed from Rephidim, entered the wilderness of Sinai, and camped in the wilderness. Israel camped there in front of the mountain. Then Moses went up to God. The Lord called to him from the mountain, saying, "Thus you shall say to the house of Jacob and tell the Israelites, you have seen what I have done to the Egyptians and how I bore you on eagle's wings and brought you to myself. Now, therefore, if you obey my voice and keep my covenant, you shall be my treasured possession out of all the peoples. Indeed, the whole earth is mine, but you shall be for me a priestly kingdom and a holy nation. These are the words that you shall speak to the Israelites." So Moses came, some of the elders of the people, and set before them all the words that the Lord had commanded. The people all answered as one, "Everything that the Lord has spoken, we will do." We will read responsibly from Psalm 100. "Make a joyful noise to the Lord, all you lands. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come into God's presence with a song.
Know that the Lord is God, our Maker, to whom we belong. We are God's people and the sheep of God's pasture.
Enter the gates of the Lord with thanksgiving and the courts with praise. Give thanks and bless God's holy name.
Good indeed is the Lord, whose steadfast love is everlasting, whose faithfulness endures from age to age."
Our second reading is from the 5th chapter of Romans. "Since we are justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have obtained access to this grace in which we stand. We boast in our hope of sharing the glory of God. And not only that, but we also boast in our sufferings, knowing that suffering produces endurance, and endurance produces character, and character produces hope. And hope does not disappoint us, because God's love has been poured into our hearts through the Holy Spirit that has been given to us. For a while we were still weak. At the right time, Christ died for the ungodly. Indeed, rarely will anyone die for a righteous person, though perhaps for a good person, someone might actually dare to die. But God provides his love for us in what we still were sinners, Christ died for us." Word of God, word of life. Thanks be to God.
Good news that you bring.
The Holy Gospel according to Matthew, the 9th chapter.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus went about all the cities and villages, teaching in their synagogues and proclaiming the good news of the kingdom and curing every disease and every sickness. When he saw the crowds, he had compassion for them because they were harassed and helpless, like sheep without a shepherd. Then he said to his disciples, "The harvest is plentiful, but the laborers are few. Therefore, ask the Lord of the harvest to send out laborers into his harvest." Then Jesus summoned his 12 disciples and gave them authority over unclean spirits to cast them out and to cure every disease and every sickness. These are the names of the 12 apostles. First, Simon, also known as Peter, and his brother Andrew, James, son of Zebedee, and his brother John, Philip and Bartholomew, Thomas and Matthew, the tax collector, James, son of Alphaeus and Thaddeus, Simon the Cananean, and Judas Iscariot, the one who betrayed him. These 12 Jesus sent out with the following instructions: "Go nowhere among the Gentiles and enter no town of the Samaritans, but go rather to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. As you go, proclaim the good news. The kingdom of heaven has come near. Cure the sick, raise the dead, cleanse the lepers, cast out demons. You received without payment, give without payment." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Grace be unto you and peace from God our Father, and from our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. We thank Chip for serving as the substitute reader today. It's always glad when we can provide new experiences in the church for people. If you recall back a few months ago in my sermon, Chip served as the 18th camel today. Now, we're not talking about camels today, but we are going to talk about eagles. Not the sports kind, the avian kind. Occasionally, we see news reports about eagles, about how they're returning to a habitat or how they are breeding. The eagle is considered the mighty of the living creatures that fly. Its wingspread can be 7 feet. It can carry an animal several times its own weight and fly to the top of a mountain. God spoke of an eagle like this when he said to the Hebrew people, "I bore you on eagle's wings and brought you to myself." Our first reading today, we hear of the Hebrew people as they are in the desert. They have left Egypt, and they're traveling towards their homeland. Moses led them out of their captivity in Egypt. The people have been freed from slavery, and at last they arrive at this mountain, where they will learn to serve God rather than Pharaoh. Soon, at this place, they will be given the Ten Commandments. But before they do, God reminds them in this place that he is with them. He reminds them of how he has saved them and led them to this place. The Hebrews pitched their tents opposite the mountain. And as they camped there for several days, they must have seen the eagle soaring from that mountain. Perhaps they watched astonished as an eagle snatched a lamb or a young goat from the flock and carried it high to the mountain to feed its young. In the same way, God is saying, he has carried them. They are his people, and he has carried them. He snatched them out of their slavery. He took all the Hebrew people, everyone in Egypt, and has carried them out of slavery and brought them on this path toward their homeland. Later on, as the Hebrews travel further, God uses another figure of speech in a powerful promise. He says, underneath are the everlasting arms. Underneath what? The promise has a blank space which we can fill in. Whatever crushing tragedy or burden or sorrow, whatever intense suffering or bitter disappointment you may experience, underneath are the everlasting arms of God. An explorer was taking measurements of the depth of the Arctic Ocean. As he measured the depth of the ocean floor, he would sometimes come to places where his line would not reach the bottom. It was so deep that his line wouldn't go the whole way to the bottom. So at each of those places, he would write in his logbook the length of the line he had. And after it, he wrote the words, deeper than that. When we can't touch the bottom in life, because of some shock or sudden catastrophe or some overwhelming blow, then those everlasting arms of God reach way down, deeper than that. They reach down and bear us up. They lift us up. I bore you on eagle's wings and have brought you to myself. A promise that God still makes to us. A father was teaching his son how to swim in a lake. After showing the son how to move his arms and kick his legs, he placed his son flat on the surface of the water. The father kept his strong arms underneath his son. At the times in the process of trying to swim, a large wave would wash over the boy's head. He would emerge sputtering and choking and panicked. But those strong arms were always underneath so that he would not sink, regardless of the strength of the waves. Without those arms of his father underneath him, the boy would not have made it. But with those arms underneath, the boy could not sink. God promises us. His arms are underneath us. He carries us on eagle's wings. A small town in the French Pyrenees has a shrine noted for its miracle of healing. One day, an amputee came there. A bystander saw this amputee hobbling up to the shrine. The bystander asked this man, "Does this man think that he will get back his leg?" Overhearing the question, the amputee answered, "No, I don't expect God to give me back my leg. I am going to pray to him to help me live without it." And God can. God has those eagle's wings to support us, to help us in whatever we face. Whatever burdens we carry in this life, the most important question is not how much you carry, The most important question is, who carries you? As one writer has stated, God never puts a burden on you without first putting his own arms underneath you. There are times that we cannot make it on our own. Some of us then turn to support systems that might be called sparrow's wings. They have very little lifting power at all. They flap and flutter, but they cannot lift a heavy weight. Many people today, when facing such burdens of life, turn to social media and find that there's not much help at all. In the book of Revelation, when the woman God supported was pursued by the dragon, she was given two wings of a large eagle to fly away. When you face your own dragon, you don't want the wings of a sparrow. You want nothing less than eagle's wings. And that is what God has promised us. I have carried you on eagle's wings and have brought you to myself. There is no load so heavy that God's wings cannot lift. There is no burden so great that those everlasting arms underneath will break. Notice where the apostrophe is in the word eagles. It's after the S. That signifies eagles, plural. Not just the powerful wings of one eagle, but the mighty wings of a whole flock are bearing up God's people. God lifted up the Israelites, and God uses us to lift up people. God uses us to help sustain people in trouble. We become the feathers in those eagle's wings. We can help carry other people over tragedy, loneliness, disappointment, grief. I'm told that an eagle may have as many as 25,000 feathers. So a flock of eagle's wings, flock of eagles would have hundreds of thousands of feathers. We can be one of those feathers on those wings that God uses to lift up his people. That is what Jesus was saying to his disciples, as we heard in our gospel reading today, and he was calling them and telling them of their work. They could be feathers of an eagle to help lift up other people. Recall another story from the Bible. Some friends wanted to bring a paralytic to Jesus. They thought Jesus could heal him. They carry the paralytic on a litter. When they cannot enter the house where Jesus was because of a large crowd, they carry the man up some outside steps as on eagle's wings. And then they make a hole in a roof and lower the man down through the hole. Seeing what God has done, the Israelites that day there in the desert respond with praise and a promise of obedience. Now, we know that those Israelites won't always be obedient. But they keep coming back to recalling that God had carried them through their worst times. Jesus, again, as he calls the 12 disciples, reminding us of the 12 tribes of the Israelites. As Jesus calls those 12 disciples, like these Israelites, these new disciples are to proclaim the same mighty acts of God. They are to tell people that God continues to save them, just as the Israelites promised to do. The task given the Israelites, the task Jesus gave the disciples, is that same task given us. Recall how God has lifted us. Tell others how God can lift them. And then give praise to God for his mighty acts. Because Jesus has carried you from the pit of hopelessness to the height of glory by his death and resurrection, we can help carry others through whatever they may be facing. This is the week of the United States Open Golf Tournament. So we use golf language. As you see others around you going through trouble, make yourself not a birdie for them, make yourself an eagle. God carried the Hebrew people on eagle's wings a long way from their slavery in Egypt to prosperity in the promised land. He is eager to carry you on eagle's wings from your earthly pilgrimage, from the existence of sin and death in this life, to the soaring sunlight and forgiveness of eternal life. As God lifts you, take the hand of someone, someone near you who is going through a dark valley, so that God may lift that person also to the sunny mountaintop with him. Amen.
You who dwell in the shelter of the Lord, who abide in the shadow of our life, say to the Lord, my refuge, my rock, in whom I trust. He will raise you up on eagle's wings, shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand. The snare of the Father will never capture you, and famine will bring you no fear. Under God's wings, your with faithfulness, your shield, and he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn.
descend.
You need not fear the terror of the night, nor the arrow that flies by day. Though thousands fall about you, near you shall not come,
and he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you up the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand.
A storm,
and he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand.
Trusting in God's abundant mercy, let us offer our prayers for a world in need. We pray for the church here and around the world. Seek out disciples and send them out with authority to proclaim good news. Bring healing where there is pain and counter the forces of evil. God, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for the earth and all its creatures. Equip farmers, farm workers, and all who labor on the land to produce a harvest. Nourish crops with ample rainfall and abundant sunshine. Restore lands ruined by pollution or misuse. God, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for those who govern. Empower those who seek peaceful solutions to conflict, and strengthen those who advocate for all who are oppressed. Work through systems of government to establish justice and peace throughout the world. Send consolation to those who suffer due to war, conflict, prejudice, or injustice. God, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for those who suffer. Accompany those who feel helpless, alone, or abandoned. Embrace any who long for successful treatment for mental illness or freedom from addiction. Heal all who are sick in body, mind, or spirit. We pray especially for Jim Bomberger, Dennis Buchanan, Kelly Diodario, Donna Dixon, Jerry Fickling, Wally Folkrod, Janice Geiling, Glenn Hoffa, Diane Holobeck, Dean Huebner, Mary Huebner, Joe Lewin, Laura McEwen, Nancy Miller, Chip Murray, Donna Pastick, Tom Rieger, Val Rowe, Ed Schaefer, Bob Seibert, Beverly Sponoggle, Irene Tarazi, Bob Warden, Mike Weldy, and all those we either name aloud or in our hearts. God, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for fathers, father figures, and all who nurture the growth of the young among us. Bless them as they strive to be good caregivers and role models. We also pray for those with difficult emotions this day. Console all who long to be fathers, children estranged from their fathers, anyone grieving the death of a father, and fathers who have lost a child. God, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for all the saints and give thanks for the blessings given during their lives. Receive all who have died into your eternal care and fill us with hope that one day we will be reunited with all the blessed saints living in your kingdom. Console all who mourn the loss of a loved one. We pray especially for the family of Barb Walker. God, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Receive our prayers and answer us, O God, in the name of Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
Amen. Amen.
The peace of Christ be with you always.
And also with you.
Please share that peace with one another.
Let us pray. God of field and forest, sea and sky, you are the giver of all good things. Sustain us with these gifts of your creation and multiply your graciousness in us, that the world may be fed with your love through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, almighty and merciful God, through our Savior Jesus Christ, who on this day overcame death and the grave, and by his glorious resurrection, opened to us the way of everlasting life. And so, with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn.
Holy, holy.
In which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people, for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come,
thy will
be done,
on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread,
and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
And lead us not into temptation,
but deliver us from evil.
For thine is the kingdom,
the power,
and the glory,
forever and ever.
Amen.
Taste and see that the Lord is good.
Thanks be to God.
The blood of Christ shed for you.
The blood of Christ shed for you. The blood of Christ shed for you. The blood of Christ shed for you.
the body and blood of Christ, strengthen you and keep you in his grace.
Amen.
Let us pray. We thank you, generous God, for the refreshment we have received at your banquet table. Send us now to spread your generosity into the world through the one who is our dearest treasure, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
Amen. Amen.
The God who calls across the cosmos and speaks in the smallest seed, bless and keep and sustain you now and until the end of the age.
Amen.
Go in peace, share the harvest.
Thanks be to God.